This is the Blaring Out with Eric Blair show tonight, interviewing rockers on the red carpet for the Ronnie James Dio Stand Up and Shout Cancer Fund's third annual Bowl for Ronnie event. Mickey, tell me about your relationship with Ronnie James Dio. How did he touch your life?
Oh, my Lord, yeah. Ronnie, one of the nicest guys in the business. I've been a great fan since he actually started singing, and we had such a great relationship with, especially of course, Motorhead and Dio. But ever since the Rainbow days, and me and Ronnie, we kind of clicked great together. Yeah, what can you say about one of the greatest singer ever?
When you look at Lemmy's legacy and Motorhead's legacy now, it seems to be bigger than ever. How did you deal with the passing of Lemmy?
Well, I gotta tell you, a lot of people call it a disaster. I don't. I know Lemmy, I knew him so well, and this might sound really weird, but I rather celebrate his life than mourn his death. Lemmy was very satisfied with his life, and he got to turn 70 years of age. He was a happy camper. Of course, I would love to for him to be around, but you know, he had a great life. And a disaster is when young people pass, or kids and accidents. And Lemmy had a great 70 years of his way or the highway. And I rather smile when I think about it. I was up yesterday to visit both Lemmy and Ronnie, and my good friend Jimmy Bain as well. I celebrate their life. These are guys that they rock and roll was their life, and they were happy guys. And Ronnie passed a little too early, and that was more like, you know, what happened. But Lemmy, he felt more prepared, and I would love to him to be around another 20 years, of course, like we all would. But he had a great life, and he told me when he was 50, if I die tomorrow, Mick, I lived a perfect life.
Why do you think the world embraced Lemmy so warmly?
Well, I don't think, I know. He was real. He was the real deal. There wasn't a fake bone in his body, and he never compromised his living or his vision or his way of life. It was his way, or our way, or Motorhead way, or he wasn't interested.
Tell me how your life has changed now playing with the Scorpions.
Extremely great. I mean, I'm so happy to be yet again getting into such a fantastic band as Scorpions, and to be a part of that, and to carry the flag as a drummer, and even feel like I'm making a change, you know? I'm helping the band, not just being a drummer sitting behind there and playing along. I take a lot of room and I enjoy that. And the guys are fantastic, and I think we have a great show, and I'm sure like Lem sitting up there or down there or wherever he is going, you know, great job, you know? And the guys, Scorpions, Motorhead, we run into each other for so many times. And the boys love Lemmy, and Lemmy love Scorpions, and yeah, it couldn't work out better, tell you the truth.
What was your time like with King Diamond?
Well, we started as a bunch of kids, really, and we created something. To tell you the truth, we really didn't know what we did. Well, we knew what we did, but that we created a style but we had so much fun and a bunch of friends touring. It all came to an end where I didn't feel very happy in the band anymore. We were going a little bit different direction than I thought that we'd been working ourselves up to, and I moved And me as a drummer, I like to play everything. I play big band jazz, fusion, pop, blues, rock, heavy metal, speed metal, you know. So to me, it was a natural move. I wanted to play some more straight ahead rock and roll, and I felt a little stressed in King Diamond in the end, maybe.
How did you feel about the satanic overtones of the King Diamond?
No, it wasn't that bad at all. I mean, King believes in the occult. more Stephen King kind of stuff. And for the rest of the four of us, we were not so much into that. But it was great music, great camaraderie, great lyrics, great. And then King's personal belief was his deal, you know. It's like I never got into Lemmy's personal vision. If you're a band, you're four or five or three people, I mean, whatever you are, everybody has their own vision and their own belief in how life is or wherever you're gonna go. And the trick is to get that to work together without people getting angry or disagreeing about. And luckily with King Diamond, we had a great teamwork. With Don, we had a great teamwork. With Motorhead, a fantastic teamwork. And with Scorpions, yeah, almost 2 years now with these guys. And we're very close, German and Swedes, you know. I love Wiener Schnitzel more than they do. So, no, it's a great, great, great deal. I'm very, very happy. I'm glad my body's working and I can stay healthy.
God bless you.
Get us both.
Survivors, not Survivor. Survivors.
Survivors. Have we ever been drowning? I don't know about that.
No, we're surviving.
We did so much great together.
Yeah.
And it's so good to see
you. Yeah, it's good because if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't have been able to reopen the hotel in the north of Sweden when it was closed in the middle of winter. Because he's the guy that walks up to the desk and says, "Do you know who I am?"
The Blaring Out Show.